When I saw this video from Louis Rossman or this one by Tom, a fellow ham radio operator, I said to myself, holy shit! I use these car fuses a lot and always expected that they protect my circuits from overcurrent and possible burning. But I never checked if they work. Particularly since I started to work with lithium batteries, capable of delivering huge currents and even burning if you are unlucky, the danger increased dramatically. Do I also have bad Chinese stuff? I am sure you want to know the truth too. So let's check out my fuses from AliExpress and Amazon and compare them with the proper ones from Bosch. And I will show you how you can test yours without expensive gear. Gritty YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent, with a new episode and fresh ideas around sensors and microcontrollers. Remember, if you subscribe, you will always sit in the first row. Fuses are an extremely important protection for all kinds of electronic circuits, including your house, car, and do-it-yourself devices. Their most important function is to create trust, because most fuses never blow during their entire life. When I saw these videos where a 5 ampere fuse hardly blew at 20 amps, my trust went away because I have similar looking ones in my lab. I regularly use them myself and even help my family and friends because of my assortments. Not good at all. Being responsible for my own faith is okay, but being responsible for somebody else's accident is not acceptable to me. But how can we test fuses? It seems to be simple. Make sure enough amperes flow through the fuse and check if it blows. Immediately, two questions come to mind. 1. How much is enough current to blow the fuse? And 2. Where do I get these amperes from? Louis could not find a datasheet for his Amazon fuses, so I took Tom's approach. Look at the datasheet of reputable suppliers and then test my fuses against these curves, because I want my fuses to behave like the original ones. As usual, there are standards. And Bosch, for example, bases their car fuses on ISO 8820. Other geographies have different standards, but the essence is the same. Such diagrams. On the x-axis, you have the current in ampere, and on the y-axis, the time in seconds. Each fuse, according to its rating, has to follow a curve. The 5 ampere type will never blow at 5 ampere, for example. But at 10 ampere should break in less than 1 second, and at 20 ampere in 0.1 seconds, not in 2 minutes, as shown in this video, or never if we believe Louis' test. So we know that we need a lot of amps for the test. Where to get it? My bench power supply only provides 6 amps, perfect for most of my normal stuff, but not enough even for the small 5 amp fuse. What should I do? Like Louis, buy a tower of new power supplies just for this test? Not possible, because I could not explain it to my wife. Not the expense, and even less the big package delivered to my small lab. She anyway suggests that I give away most of my stuff. So let's think for a minute. To blow fuses, we need amps. The voltage is not important. This is Louis' setup and this is Tom's setup. Both need a potent source of amps. Tom limits the current of the source and Louis uses resistors to limit the current. The voltage is not important because fuses have nearly no resistance and therefore the voltage across the fuse is very low before it is blown. As mentioned before, I have such sources. Li-ion or LiFePO4 batteries. They provide a ton of current. Second problem solved. Now I need to control the current so that I can show you exactly when the fuse blows, not only at the very high current delivered by a lithium battery. Fortunately, I have this electronic load capable of burning up to 30 ampere. Exactly what we need. So, this is my final setup. And the best, because the current is everywhere the same, we do not have to care about the resistance of all the wires and attachments to the fuse. At least if they are good enough not to burn. This is why I use these simple crocodile clips to connect a fuse between the plus pole of the battery and the plus pole of the load. Minus is connected directly to close the circuit. I have two Chinese fuse assortment bought quite some time ago. One standard size and one with smaller fuses for my motorcycle. In addition, I got a bag of fuses with this power distribution set, also from AliExpress. For this video, I ordered a few Bosch branded fuses for comparison and one of the standard assortments from Amazon. The Bosch fuses are manufactured in Slovenia, a European country if you never heard of it. So I have a proper setup to start my tests. A first learning. The colors seem to be standardized. All 5 ampere types are orange and all 30 ampere are green, for example. So even a noob can replace them. Very good. Let's start our test with a 5 amp fuse at 5 amps. None of them should burn. And really, after 10 minutes, all are still alive and not hot. We can measure the resistance using the so-called 4-wire method. Our setup makes sure that exactly 5 ampere flow through the fuse. If we use our multimeter to measure the voltage directly at the fuse, we can calculate the proper resistance. This is called the 4-wire method because we have 2 wires to measure the current and 2 wires to measure the voltage. This method is very precise. I leave you a link to a video if you want to know why. And here is the result. Therefore, the fuse's power dissipation is around 0.5 watt. This is not enough to get hot. Now we increase the current to 10 amps. This time I connect channel 1 of the oscilloscope across the fuse to see when it blows. To get a trigger signal for the start of the test, I connect channel 2 across the battery voltage. As soon as I switch the current on, this voltage drops a bit and so creates the trigger. As soon as the fuse blows, the voltage across it increases from nearly 0 to around 12 volts, because we measure the open voltage of the battery. For this fuse, it takes 3 seconds. Let's again check our expectations. According to the curve, this time should be below 1 second. So my Chinese no-brand fuse is not completely up to the task. But for sure much better than the ones tested by Louis or Tom. Let's continue. The Chinese no-name from Amazon was below 0.5 seconds, and the third no-name was at 0.5 seconds. Both are well inside the specs. This is extremely good news. My fuses are very different from the ones in the other videos, and even the worst, not alarming at all. So the 5 amp fuses in my lab are all okay. Let's check the 10 amp fuses at 20 amps. Also here, the same results. The one from this assortment breaks at around 3.5 seconds, and the others at or below 0.5 seconds. Also okay for me. This assortment generally seems to be a bit slow, but not dangerous if you ask me. They also do not get hot during this short time. I also measured the resistances. Of course, it gets smaller for the higher ampere fuses. A 15 ampere fuse has a resistance of 6 milliohms, and because the current is squared in the formula, it has to dissipate a maximum of more than 1 watt. As we calculated before, the small power dissipation should not heat the fuse under normal conditions, unless you use a bad fuse holder with a high resistance. Then, according to the formula, the dissipated power increases. Temperature can also increase if you place the fuse in such a holder without ventilation. Now we know that I was fortunate. But how about you? In all tests, all fuses of a particular assortment behaved the same. Either they were good, okay, or bad, as we saw in Louis and Tom's tests. So we do not need to test all of them. I suggest testing the 5 amp one with a current of about 10 amps. If it blows fast, all is well. If not, you have to dispose the whole assortment and buy a new one. Unfortunately, you do not know which one is good before you order. So buy one, test it when it arrives, and send it back or dispute it when it's bad. But how can we test our fuses? Because the bad fuses are really bad and withstand extremely high currents, I suggest the following really dirty method. Only use it if you know what you do. Preferably outside your home, because the battery can catch fire if you do not stop the experiment fast. So be warned. By the way, you will see how fast things get warm. Exactly the same will happen if your bad fuse does not blow when your circuit shortens. So you get a good impression of why I created this video and why you have to do these tests. Use an 18650 battery in a holder connected to a crocodile clip. Most of them should be able to source more than 20 amps. The second wire is connected to 3 1 ohm resistors in parallel. I use these 3 watt versions, but of course 10 watt or more are advisable. These small ones will burn. If you connect the crocodile clip to one leg of the fuse and the resistors to the other, about 10 amps should flow and blow your 5 amp fuse in under a second. If it does not blow fast, you know you have a problem. Stop the experiment because your 3 resistors as well as the battery holder are misused and get hot really fast. Maybe you even protect your hands for that experiment. The 10 amperes, by the way, is limited by all the resistances in series. This experiment will not work with an old or uncharged battery because its inner resistance will be too high. But how did the Bosch fuses behave? They were all inside the specs, as expected from a reputable brand. The only thing left is to report your findings in the video's comments, so that we can see the percentage of bad fuses in the market. That was all for today. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, please consider supporting the channel to secure its future existence. Thank you. Bye.